This is the Diehl EVM18. It's an electric calculator that has fully automatic division and semi-automatic multiplication. Addition is quite simple. You enter a number and you press the plus button and it gets added to the main register and the counter is incremented by one. With this little switch in the plus position, it automatically clears the keyboard as well. If I put this in the multiply position, the keyboard would be left on the keyboard. So with this input, you can, and this in the multiply position, you can keep the plus button down to add the number several times. With these buttons, you can shift the carriage and add this number several times at the other positions as well, and so do multiplication. It is actually easier to use these buttons on the side. If you press one of these buttons, it automatically adds this input, that number of times that you've selected, and also shifts the carriage automatically. So, if I start again, let me just return the carriage all the way to the left and clear the output. If I want to multiply this input number by 173, I simply type the 173 from right to left. So 3, 7, 1. And this is the result. It says 173 in the counter, and that's the number I entered. The interesting thing is that the 7, it wasn't done by adding it 7 times in succession. It was actually done by subtracting 3 times, shifting the carriage, then adding once. So that does minus 3 plus 10, which is a net addition of 7. And the same goes for if you add 6 times or 8 times or 9 times the input. For example, 9 times it should just do 1 subtraction, a shift, and then 1 addition. You may have noticed that the carry doesn't actually go all the way to the end of the register. The carry only occurs above the body of the machine. The carry mechanism is inside the body of the machine, and so it can't carry the register over into the left. So if I subtract 1, you can see it has 9s only going up to this 10th place. But the interesting thing is, if I shift the carriage to the right, a 9 appears here. The 0 that was out there becomes a 9. And conversely, if I now shift it back to the left again, it undoes that. So this allows this shortcut multiplication mechanism to work. If it didn't do this fix at the edge of the machine, it would have some phantom numbers appearing here when you do shortcut multiplication. So I'll clear the registers. You can press both of these buttons at the same time if you like, clearing both registers at the same time. To clear the keyboard, you press this one. That happens fully mechanically rather than powered by the motor. So that was addition and multiplication and subtraction. To do division, that's what these buttons are for. This top button tells the machine to count subtractions rather than additions, so that the counter is incremented when you subtract rather than when you add. And the bottom button will start a division. So let's do that now. First, I'll shift it all the way to the right and enter the number I want to use in the division. I'll also clear this counter now because I don't want this one that's just appeared to be there. And I'll divide that by this. So I'm doing 355 divided by 113, which is a nice approximation to pi. So I'll start this automatic division by pressing both buttons at the same time. And the result is 3.14159292, which is pretty good. The remainder of this division is 4, which remains in this in the main register. This small switch here, on slightly later models, this switch is right next to the division buttons. What this does is it allows you to stop automatic division prematurely. So once you've seen enough digits appear, you can stop it so that if you don't need any further digits in the division. It'll only do interrupt that division at the point where it would shift the carriage, or just after a shift of the carriage, I think. Because, yeah, but that does mean that you can't use this little switch to stop a division by zero. If you divide by zero, you'll just have to quickly press something on the keyboard so that it's no longer dividing by zero, and then it will eventually stop. So this is the Diehl EVM18. I'm not sure what the V stands for. The M stands for multiplication. I think VM means shortened multiplication or something like that. The E is simply the model number. They had a model series A, a B. They skipped C and had a D, and this is their series E. And 18 is, of course, the number of digits in the main register. There was also an EVM15. The company, Diehl, they only started making calculators in 1952. In 1950, some people who worked at the Archimedes factory joined Diehl. There were Ulrich Eichler, who was the son-in-law of the founder of Archimedes, and William Keel, who was the main engineer, and several other employees as well. The Archimedes factory was in Glashütte, and that was in East Germany. So after the Second World War, they saw that they needed to set up in Western Germany. And when the Archimedes factory was taken over by the state in 1948, it was clear that they couldn't really return. And so in West Germany, they developed a calculator, and with those designs, based on the original Archimedes patents as well, and pending applications that they had control over, they went to Diehl, who could develop it. It took 2 more years of development, because they joined Diehl in 1950, and the first machines came out in 1952. But after that, it went really quickly, and the Series E was first produced in 1954. And versions of this machine were produced until, I think, 1962 or so. So this was the Diehl EVM18. Thank you for watching.